we are Muslim, in one of the rules...
One of the rules, going to Hajj, you have to slaughter the animal.
You have to cut an animal's head off and please God. Ask the lamb about it, see what the lamb thinks.
You're going to get old sooner, so you're going to get wrinkled sooner.
Can you see a tomato get cut?
Logically.
You don't feel bad.
But they've got a life as well, haven't they?
Prove me wrong? Are you vegan?
Yeah, I'm vegetarian.
You're vegetarian? Well, you're not vegan?
No.
So you support animal abuse?
Okay.
Prove me wrong.
Are you preachy?
Hey?
Are you preachy?
Very preachy. The most preachy.
Are we the same?
Sorry?
Are we the same? She's not the same,
and you're
vegetarian. I'm vegetarian, and so are we the same? You're treating both the same?
Do you think we are the same?
I understand. I'm thinking. Basically, yeah.
Yeah.
Practically, yeah.
So for 5 years, I wasted my time.
Yes, you did.
When you're a vegetarian, you eat milk and eggs.
Yeah. But we use organic, so it's...
Organic milk and organic eggs.
Yeah.
So always.
So we're thinking they are being treated in a good way and they are being helped.
In the UK? You live in the UK?
Yeah.
You stay in the UK often?
Yeah, yeah. We came from Leeds.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you only eat organic eggs and organic milk in the UK?
Yes. Yeah.
Only?
Yeah. Cheese as well.
So when you
not
go...
only dairy, for vegetable, for fruits,
everything. Organic.
We go for organic, actually.
So when you go to... when you eat it, you don't eat at restaurants, you don't eat anywhere?
Oh, yeah, we do.
Yeah.
So
this is what I mean, like only or when you try to?
Pizza, there's no milk.
So when you go for pizza, like you go cheese,
pizza?
Cheese.
Yeah.
So you don't
but
want.
We don't eat pizza every day, maybe 2 weeks a time.
We know going for restaurant regularly.
No.
The hygiene and then lifestyle, health lifestyle.
Okay.
So maybe we go to the restaurant twice or three times a month. So no more.
So organic, right? I mean, you eat meat, dairy, eggs, fish. You eat fish?
Everything.
You don't eat fish?
Everything, no.
No meat from any
other? I'm vegetarian.
I
know pescetarian, laxetarian, vegan, raw vegan. I know everything.
Okay. Do you eat their bodies?
Oh, yeah.
And you don't eat their bodies? That's the difference?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you wear their skin?
No.
Fur?
No.
For leather?
I always check their... You know, she's not the same as well.
Not the same.
Sometimes you buy second-hand belts.
So if you eat beef, do you eat cows?
Yeah.
They might have come from your consumption of dairy.
Yes.
50% of the beef comes from the dairy industry. So those cows that you get your milk from, they go to the slaughterhouse. Do you know that?
Yeah.
Yeah, sometimes. Because I have seen a program about the killing the calf in the dairy farm.
The milk.
Most of them. But some of them, they keep the calf.
With the mum.
Yes, and keep the calf aside because they don't want to take the milk from the mum. Maybe once a week.
That's a standard practice.
Yeah.
That's most dairy farms in the world do that.
But mostly they kill the calf.
Yeah, they do. And this is the... So you know this?
Yeah, I just knew about that.
Okay.
Last week I seen a program.
So if you know about that, then you know that these industries, but in the dairy industry, it's separating families.
Yeah.
The calf from the mother.
Yeah. So you said the calf from the dairy farm.
Yeah.
The milk comes for me, and the meat goes for her.
The meat industry and the veal industry and the beef industry are supported by the dairy industry. They're connected very intrinsically.
Yeah.
Because all of those dairy cows go to the slaughterhouse and are eaten.
Yeah.
For burgers.
Or even the killing in the when they're born.
Or maybe on the first day of life, they can sometimes kill them, the calves. But what they're doing in the dairy industry in the UK now is they're using the dairy cows, they're impregnating them with semen for a beef breed. So then the dairy cow gives birth to a beef calf. They raise the calf to be killed for the beef industry.
Okay.
So the dairy industry and the meat industry are like this.
Okay. Thinking to be a vegan, okay?
Yeah.
Not just vegetarian.
Yeah.
But I have like a few questions in my mind always. Can you just answer me that on
the of course.
Health weight if you have information?
Okay.
Because doctors and so like those people saying if you're not eating meat or collagen or stuff like that, you're gonna get old sooner, so you're gonna get wrinkled sooner. You're not gonna be like those people have a strong muscles and then you just feel fatigued, you feel tired, you're losing vitamin B12. Sometimes
B6,
and then I tried.
I'm losing my hair actually right now because of B12.
We are living together.
I supplement with B12.
But
Is it the same?
You should always supplement with B12.
I take B12 supplement, no help.
It's not like
you're still deficient?
I have it.
Yeah. You have to well then you have absorption issues. This is different. You can eat meat and be deficient in B12.
Because most
people who are
mineral and then those vitamins on the vegetable is not exactly the same on the animal. Because the way you're absorbing vegetables and then those mineral is different from your absorbing from the meat. So
Give me an example.
What
mineral do you think?
B12, B6.
Yeah, B12 doesn't come from animals. It's in animals, but it doesn't come from animals.
It's come from the grass.
It's a bacteria that exists in the soil that produce B12. But it's a good source of B12 to eat it from animals, but I'm a good source of B12. You wouldn't eat me. And you can supplement B12 really easily. And most of the fortified food, like the cereals and the soya milks and all that, they have B12 fortified in them. Like a supplement?
It says you don't feel strong enough, you know, you feel fatigued, you feel tired if you're not eating.
Can you make muscle when you are vegan?
Yeah. So you're talking about, is there protein in plants? Amino acids. I think there's 20 amino acids. 9 of them are essential. All 9 essential amino acids are found in all plants, but in varying degrees. So you might get some beans, they've got more protein. You might get some lettuce, they've got less protein, but even lettuce has all the amino acids, but you just have to eat a variety of food and enough food. So if you're getting enough calories, 2,000 calories, if you're not eating enough, you might get tired. You might not get enough nutrients. You might get weak hair. You might start to feel fatigued. But if you're eating enough food, so what people do is they stop eating cheese, meat, eggs, and then they start eating vegetables.
Yeah.
And vegetables have less calories. So when you take calories away, you have to replace those calories. And not with lettuce or broccoli, with beans and bread and nuts and seeds.
Chickpeas.
And
lentils.
Yeah, lentils and hummus and, you know, calorie-dense foods and vegetables and fruits and dried fruits. But so you're eating enough calories. Because if you have a plate of food like this, it's got cheese there, eggs there, meat there, you take those out, you add more vegetables and you have the same amount of food, the calories are going to be a lot less. And this is the main problem, that when people go vegan, they start eating less calories, the same amount of food and less calories.
It has to be carb, like everyday chickpeas or beans or stuff like that.
Yeah, they're very healthy, full of fiber, much healthier than meat. There's no fiber in meat. Meat has cholesterol in there. Red meats are a probable cause of cancer, so a class 2A carcinogen. Processed meats like bacon and ham is a type 1 carcinogen. Eggs are filled with cholesterol, but these industries exploit and harm and kill animals. Even on organic farms, they go to the same slaughterhouse as the rest of the animals. You seem like good, really good people. But if you've seen what's inside of a slaughterhouse, there's something out of the depths of a horror movie, hell.
Yeah, of course.
There's blood, there's fear, animals crap themselves out of fear, they don't want to die.
We have a problem, actually, for here as well, we are Muslim. In one of the rules, the animals should not be slaughtered in front of each other.
Halal slaughter.
Yeah, we can't find halal like this slaughtered. No, because they are slaughtering in the same place. They see each other, they hear each other. This is not halal.
Halal is interesting too, because I talk to Muslims all the time as well. You eat milk and eggs. Do you think those dairy cows go to a halal slaughterhouse?
No.
When they wrote the halal guidelines in the hadiths, is it hadiths? Where the halal...
It's Quran and hadiths, both.
Okay, dairy was not an industry back then. Milk was not an industry. Now milk is an industry.
Yeah.
Do you think milk is halal? They didn't account for it. Well, they didn't account for it.
If you're not toxic, yes.
Well, they separate the families.
All right, yeah.
They...
But what about the Hajj? People every year going to Mecca, and then one of the rules, going to Hajj, you have to slaughter the animal to
give it
to the charity. Do you know what I mean? So what about that? If I am a vegan, am I still allowed to do that?
I wouldn't do it. There's no reason you have to sacrifice an animal in order to make a sacrifice.
Well, it's a rule, isn't it?
It's not a rule.
It's a rule to be accepted.
There is no rule to sacrifice. You have to hold the knife and kill an animal in order to go to the Mecca.
No, it's one of the rules in the Mecca when you do. So the pilgrimage is about so many rules when you're doing it. So one of them
is sacrifice an animal.
Sacrifice an animal and give it to the poor people. Do you know what I mean?
Reality.
This is not. It's not a rule in the Quran.
It is. It's a story behind it. behind it. No. Otherwise, a man should be slaughtered instead of the animal. So it's a story.
Is it haram not to sacrifice an animal?
No, it's not completed.
It's one of the rules. If you've not done that, so that means it's not.
Why do you have to sacrifice an animal? Because of
Abraham. Because of Abraham is not being sacrificed.
So you won't complete your pilgrimage unless you kill an animal.
They don't say you won't kill an animal.
Yeah.
Because you vegans say that. They seen this as a doing good deed. You say kill, but they don't say kill. They say it's a good deed.
Basically,
I'm vegetarian. I know what it is. Yeah. I know both sides.
Yeah, no, that's interesting. So
Abraham had a chat with a god, and then God asked him to slaughter the son.
And he gave him a lamb and said...
What
if he gave him, like, something else other than the lamb?
So, this is different.
But what I'm saying is that you can make sacrifices as a Muslim that don't involve cutting animals' heads off.
No, she asking me if I go to...
If you go, will you do it?
I don't do that at all.
I don't think God will punish you for not doing that.
No.
And I think you can give to the poor and make sacrifice. So let's just say you're going to sacrifice. Well, you can sacrifice someone else without their permission. Or you can sacrifice something from yourself, like your time and your energy, to help poor people. Like, you think this is bad in God's eyes? I don't know. You have to cut an animal's head off to please God?
But you cannot do in the playground. That's fine.
Ask the lamb about it. See what the lamb thinks.
So
what about the choices? No. If you're being a vegan, you don't have enough choices to eat. That's why.
Okay. So let me ask you this. You're saying you might not complete your pilgrimage, but why do you pay for the animals to have their heads cut off without pilgrimage, just during the day, just usually?
Like paying the money instead of...
Yeah, well, you pay people in slaughterhouses to kill animals.
I've thought about that as well. So I have
could you pay me to kill a cow right now?
No.
What about the halal way? This is Daisy the cow.
Yeah.
Okay. We face the cow to Mecca.
Okay.
I do the proper prayer. I grab the sharp knife. I cut through to the back of their throat, through their whatever this artery is. And you see the cow struggling, bleeding.
I've seen it in my life, to be honest.
Do the cows go willingly?
No, actually.
Do they try to struggle and breathe?
No, yes.
They're trying to survive.
And I feel bad, and sometimes they cry, and then I said, oh, it's
cool. Yeah. It doesn't seem like they wanted to be sacrificed.
Well, no.
Yeah. So you couldn't pay me to kill the cow, but you pay other people to do it all the time when you don't see it.
Yes.
If God wanted you to eat animals, why do you feel bad when you see them be killed? When you make a choice, what do you listen to? When you make a decision?
Heart
or mind?
You use your conscience and your mind and your logic. And who gave those to you? Who gave you your conscience? Who do you believe gave you your conscience?
It's inside you.
Yeah.
Who created you?
Oh, God.
Oh, God. Allah.
Yeah.
Okay. When you see an animal be slaughtered in the halal way, what does your heart say?
But she's not looking at the situation.
I'm not looking at them.
Because she doesn't know.
If I look at them, it's gonna be really touching.
Okay.
Maybe before she was okay, and I was okay. I did sacrifice in my home actually for the dead people. But now, when I'm talking about this at home, we've seen lots of program, TV show, and she always changes.
Yeah.
And she eats less meat because of
this. I don't
this.
Think you could kill an animal, personally. I don't think you or you...
No.
Maybe if you were forced to, maybe you could.
No.
But I don't think you'd feel good about it.
Can I have one more question, please?
Yeah, after this. Because I really want to get to this point here.
Okay.
If God created you, you have a conscience, right? This is Allah you're talking about, the most intelligent creator ever, right? Now, there is many books, I get there's books, right? And one, the Quran is like the last word of God, like this is like unchanged, God will protect this. But you were also created by God.
Yeah.
I think this is better proof.
Yeah.
This is really good proof.
Yes.
When an animal doesn't want to die, you don't want to kill them. If you believe in God, that has to be God speaking to you. When you eat an apple,
I'm weak about my choices. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So every time he tell me, I don't feel like to have any meat in my meals or anything like that. And then when I'm cooking it at home, he says, "Oh, do you not like it when it gets smell or anything like that?" He said, "No, I'm absolutely fine." And I'm just saying, "Oh, if I go somewhere, it smells kebab or something like that, or
okay,
grill or those nice things. I'm not going to be like, do you know what
delicious.
I mean?
Delicious.
So I can't stand it.
I get it. So, but when you eat beans, rice, hummus, when you eat bread and hummus and chickpeas, when you boil it, when you cut a tomato, you don't feel the same way as when you see a cow get their head cut off, do you?
Yeah, but...
So you see a tomato get cut, you don't feel bad?
No.
But they've got a life as well, haven't they? They have plants as well.
Do you care about a tomato?
No, but they have plants as well. Prove me they're not
I don't
plant.
Care. I don't care if they're alive.
They would live breathe as well.
I don't care if a tree's alive. There's no brain there. There's no one inside of there. Like, you both are subjects of a life. Like, there's someone in there. In a chicken, they're a subject. In that pigeon there, there's a subject. They want to avoid pain and distress, and they want to... A tree is rooted into the ground. There's no brain, no nervous system, no subject. There's no one in there. When you look into the eyes of an animal, there's someone in there, you know? So you also...
So my question was only when I wanted to talk to you. Are we the same?
Are you the same?
You gave me only one proof that
I don't think
same.
You can tell her because you still support two of the industries
that...
You? No. If she's saying...
Vegetarian or vegan.
Sometimes you just suggest that when you see like climate change TV program...
Okay, yeah.
I said we are overpopulation. Yeah. We don't need to...
Well, here's another one for God as well, because
yeah,
Muslims... Muslims, they still want to eat animals, even though it's destroying God's earth. So God would have accounted for population growth.
But I think...
God would have accounted for population growth.
I always tell him if I'm not destroying the earth and animal because I'm eating once a week or twice a week, so it's not...
It doesn't matter, like, I still think... So when you eat a piece of meat, right, imagine how much food went into that animal to water food to grow that animal. It's the most unsustainable thing we do, is feed animals to kill them and eat them.
That was my question previously, if I said, can I ask her?
Yeah, okay, let's go.
So, if you've been made in the sustainable way, do you still become a vegan, or do you still suggest veganism is the best way to do, or the best way to live?
I don't think you can sustainably feed the population with animals. I think it's impossible. Even if you could, I still wouldn't agree with killing the animal. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. You know, I wouldn't want to have my children taken for dairy. I wouldn't want to be killed in a slaughterhouse. I wouldn't want to be sacrificed to Allah. So,
on YouTube, man.
Hey, brother.
That
cheers, mate.
You're brilliant.
Thank you very much, brother. Before you go, scan with your phone. You're both good people, by the way. I know you are.
Thank you.
Okay. It's nice to meet you.
It was really nice to meet you too.
Thank you.
Take care. See you later.
Bye.
They're a lovely couple, weren't they? Really nice. I think they're almost there. Just needed a little bit of help. But yeah, if you ask the animals if they want to be sacrificed, it's definitely a no. Not everyone follows every part of their religion, you know what I'm saying? So people like to pick and choose out of religions. You know, you're not praying five times a day. You're not doing lots of things in your religion. So why not take the cruel parts out and follow God and your religion? I mean, that's what I don't get. I think usually it's because people want to use the religion to justify something they want to do, they prefer to do, which is eat meat, you know? So they're using it to justify it. But it's not a requirement in any religion to kill and eat animals. In fact, if you look at what God would want, it was probably not to destroy their earth and not to torture their animals and to kill their creation with heart disease and cancer, you know, from eating processed meat, animal products, and so yeah.
I decided to become a vegan.
You're a vegan now?
No,
oh, that's a... Don't play that joke on me.
He said, I'm going to go back to the eat meat as well, because he said we don't have a both a difference, so he said, I'm going to eat meat again. So I'm joking.
Oh, that's even worse.
No, I'm joking.
Okay. And what about you? Are you going to still eat animals?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Apologise to the animals, not me. I mean, it doesn't hurt me.
Apologising the animals.
It hurts the animals, yeah. Not, you know.
Thank you, no very worries. Much. Nice to see you. Take
see
care.
See you later. Bye-bye. I actually thought maybe they were affected in some way by that conversation, but obviously not.